Which one of these do you think trapezoidal rule does a better job estimating? This one? Or this one? When we first study integrals and we learn different rules for approximating the area under the curve, like midpoint rule, trapezoidal rule, and Simpson's rule, we usually spend a lot of time talking about how accurate they are. In general, when the function is concave down, trapezoidal rule will underestimate the area. And when it's concave up, trapezoidal rule will overestimate the area. Here's why. When you're drawing trapezoids to approximate the area, you always connect the left and right sides of the trapezoid to the curve, and then you connect those points to form the top of the trapezoid. So if the curve is concave down, you'd connect your points, and then you'd end up with all these little gaps at the top. Those gaps are part of the area under the curve, but they don't get included in the trapezoidal rule estimate. So in this case, trapezoidal rule is going to underestimate the area. Exactly the opposite is true when the curve is concave up. You'd connect the points for each trapezoid, and you'd end up with all these little extra pieces of area above the curve. Those extra little pieces aren't part of the area under the curve, but they're going to get included in the trapezoidal rule estimate, so in this case, trapezoidal rule is going to overestimate the area. So if trapezoidal rule underestimates a curve that's concave down, and overestimates a curve that's concave up, what kind of function do you think you have in order for trapezoidal rule to find exact area? You guessed it, whenever the function is linear, which means whenever the curve is a straight line. So remember, when it comes to trapezoidal rule, doesn't include enough area, includes too much area, and finds exact area.